Welcome, today we will see how to program a PLC for a bottle blowing machine using timers. We will try to keep the things as simple as possible so that we can have an idea how the latter logic works. Before starting today's session, I would like you guys to please subscribe this channel for more upcoming video tutorials. Now let's quickly see the machine and how its parts are connected and how they are working. We have a blowing nozzle cylinder solenoid, which is connected at the Y1 output terminal of the PLC. When Y1 output is high, the blowing nozzle comes down and seals the mold. Next, we have a stretching cylinder solenoid, which is connected at the PLC output Y2, so when Y2 output goes high, the stretch rod moves down and goes into the mold. Next, inside the machine, there is a mold locking cylinder. This cylinder solenoid is connected at the PLC output Y0. When Y0 output goes high, this cylinder will move the moving part of the mold and locks this part of this mold with the other half of the mold. Next, we have two push buttons, green and red, to start and stop the blowing cycle. These push buttons are connected at X0 and X1 PLC inputs. Next, we have connected the pre-blow and blow valves at the PLC outputs Y3 and Y4 terminals. These valves will supply the compressed air to the preform and change its shape to a bottle. Next, we have an exhaust valve connected at the PLC output Y5. This valve is used to exhaust the compressed air inside the bottle after the blowing cycle has been completed. So, let's see how the program is controlling these inputs and outputs for this blowing machine. In the run 1, as we press the X0 start push button, it will hold on the M0 bit, which is called a cycle start bit. X1 push button will unlatch the M0 cycle start bit. Cycle start bit M0 will start the T0 mold close timer. T0 timer will start T1 nozzle down timer, and once nozzle down timer is over, it will start T2 stretch timer. Similar way, we have assigned the functions to next timers, like pre-blow, blow and exhaust timer. All of these timers will operate and activated from top to bottom. Once exhaust timer is over, it will reset the M0 cycle start bit and all other timers as well. In rung number 49, M0 cycle start bit will turn on Y0 mold close solenoid. This will close and lock the mold. In the next rung, when mold close timer bit T0 is on, this confirms that the mold is closed and it will turn on the nozzle cylinder solenoid Y1. This will bring down the blowing nozzle. In the next rung, when T1 nozzle down timer bit is on, this confirms that the blowing nozzle is down and in place, and this will turn on the stretching cylinder solenoid valve Y2, and stretching cylinder will come down and goes into the mold. In the next rung, when stretch timer T2 bit is on, this confirms that the stretching rod has started moving, and this will turn on the pre-blow valve Y3. Pre-blow valve will supply the initial compressed air pressure in the preform to start blowing the preform. In the next rung, when T3 pre-blow timer bit is on, this confirms that the pre-blow pressure has been applied, and now this will turn on the main blowing valve Y4. Main blowing final will apply the compressed air in the preform, and preform takes the shape of the bottle. Once T4 blowing valve timer bit is on, this means that blowing pressure is fully applied to the preform, and bottle is formed inside the mold, and this will turn on the exhaust valve Y5. Exhaust valve will exhaust the compressed air from the bottle so that mold can be opened safely. You can see that we insert normal close contacts of blowing valve Y4 and exhaust valve Y5 in rung 51 and rung 55. This means that when blowing valve Y4 turns on, this will turn off pre-blow valve Y3 and stretching cylinder valve Y2. Next, we insert normal close contact of the exhaust valve Y5 in rung 59. This means that when exhaust valve Y5 turns on, this will turn off blowing valve Y4. Now let's upload this program in the PLC and see how it works. Blowing machine is ready now for the test. Let's put a heated preform in the machine. As we press the green push button, it will latch on the blowing cycle bit M0, and PLC output Y0 mold close turns on and mold starts to close. As soon as mold close timer T0 is over, this will turn on the blowing nozzle cylinder Y1 and blowing nozzles comes down and seals the mold. Now, as soon as nozzle down timer T1 is over, it will turn on the stretch rod cylinder and stretch rod moves down, and it stretches the preform. In the next step, the pre-blow valve Y3 turns on, and it applies the initial pre-blow pressure, and preform starts to take the shape of the bottle. Next step, main blowing valves Y4 opens after the pre-blow timer is over, it will apply the full blowing compressed air pressure, and preform takes full shape of the bottle. Now, as the blowing timer T4 is over, it will turn on the exhaust valve Y5, it will exhaust the air pressure inside the mold, so that we can open the mold safely. When the exhaust duration timer T5 is over, it will reset the blowing cycle and all outputs goes low. Nozzle cylinder moves up, mold opens, and machine is now ready for the next cycle. So, this how we can make a basic program for the blowing machine. That's the end of the today's tutorial. Please share, like, and subscribe for more. Till next time, take care and goodbye.